What are people searching for on YouTube? That is the question we're going to answer in this video. And I'm going to show you how to do it using a really cool technique of actually working backwards. Now, if you've been in this industry for a while, you know that back in 2014, Google removed the YouTube search volume tool, which would give you the search volume amounts for the keywords typed into YouTube. And that left a real predicament for those just starting out on YouTube and even those who'd been in the industry for some time doing video marketing. And the dilemma was that how do you know which topics have the most views? How do you know how many searches are being performed each month for each topic? So consider someone who has a fishing channel. Should they be making videos about bass fishing boat or bass fishing lures, or maybe bass fishing rods or bass fishing shirts? Maybe someone has a crochet channel. Should they focus on crochet braids or crochet tops, crochet hairstyles or crochet hair? Two completely different markets. There's braid styles, there's braids for kids. Maybe it's an RC channel. And you're trying to figure out which of these keywords you should be spending your time creating videos around. The problem is most people just simply suggest to go to the Google AdWords keyword tool and do a search. The Google AdWords keyword tool is not the best indicator for search volume on YouTube. So what does work? Well, let me show you exactly what you can do to crack this problem and instantly know which keywords have the most search volume on YouTube. Let me give you a quick example to demonstrate the logic behind why this works. So let's say that we have this large group of people that are attending a Facebook marketing conference. Okay? So this large group of people right here, they're attending a Facebook marketing conference. And let's say that this group right here, all these people here, they're interested primarily in Facebook advertising. And that's the way they think about it, Facebook advertising. Now, because there's so many of them, and they all don't search the exact same way. When they go to YouTube and they search for Facebook advertising, they then create a bunch of child terms related to Facebook advertising. Now, the next group here on this side, they're mostly interested in Facebook marketing. And so when they go to YouTube and they search for videos related to Facebook marketing, they then also create another set of child terms. But because this group isn't as large and doesn't have as many people searching, they simply don't create as many child terms as the Facebook advertising group. Then we have this group up here, and they're mostly interested in Facebook retargeting. So again, smaller group, but when they go to YouTube, they don't all search the same way. But they often search for child terms related to Facebook retargeting, and the size of the group is indicative of how many new child terms will be created. Lastly, we have this small group right here, and they are mostly interested in Facebook Messenger ads. So if they go to YouTube and they search for content related to Facebook Messenger ads, they then create a very small set of child keywords, or maybe there's almost no child keywords because the group is so small. All right, now let me give you a real-world example so that you can put this concept to use. Let's say that you have a bass fishing YouTube channel, and you're trying to determine if two terms have, which of two terms has more search volume. So let's say your first option is bass fishing tips, bass fishing tips videos. So you can do A, B, there's quite a few there, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Okay, so there's quite a few child terms under bass fishing tips. And let's say you were going to compare that to bass fishing boats. Okay, so right off the bat, there's not as many children, but we'll go through A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, just simply not that many children for bass fishing boats compared to bass fishing tips. So now we know and understand because the child terms are, there's so many more child terms for the parent term bass fishing tips versus the parent term bass fishing boats, that if we want to get the biggest bang for our video marketing buck and we want to make sure we're getting lots and lots of traffic to our videos, it would be a better use of our time to rank for the term bass fishing tips and create videos around that topic than it would be to spend a whole bunch of time on videos about bass fishing boats when there just simply aren't as many searches for bass fishing boats as there are from bass fishing tips. And we know that's true because of the number of children that occur below the parent term. Okay, do you remember these keywords that I showed you earlier? Well, we wanted a way to test definitively if the logic that we're using was actually accurate and could we prove that this would actually work. Well, that gave us this idea. Everyone knows Google has a search suggestion tool. So you can put in things like bass fishing boat or bass fishing lures, and you can see the search suggestions that are populated below. What if we could take the same logic? The idea that the number of child terms indicates the popularity of the parent term, what if we could take that concept and actually prove it? Because Google has both a search suggestion feature as well as the Google AdWords keyword tool where we can get the exact match search volume for the individual keywords. Now, in order to prove this worked, here's what we did. We took two terms and we actually manually calculated how many child terms appeared below these terms. And then we asked ourselves, based on that information, which term has more search volume? And then we went back to the Google AdWords keyword tool to confirm that our information was correct. Now, let me ask you a question. Between bass fishing boat and bass fishing lures, which one do you think has the most search volume? Well, unless you're already in the bass fishing industry, you probably had a difficult time answering that question. And this is the problem for so many people that are using videos on YouTube. It's very difficult to tell which keywords have the most search volume. Now, let me show you what happened after we finished this test. You will see that 100% of the time, we were able to predict which term had the highest search volume at Google using the Google suggest child term number for each term. For instance, bass fishing boat has fewer child terms than bass fishing lures. And when we went to the Google AdWords keyword planner to confirm the information, bass fishing lures has more searches per month than bass fishing boat. The same was true for bass fishing rods compared to bass fishing shirts. Bass fishing rods has more children than bass fishing shirts, and it also happens to have more search volume than bass fishing shirts. And this was true in every single instance we tried it. When we compared the number of child terms for two terms, we were able to predict with 100% accuracy which term actually had more search volume at Google. So this is the proof of concept. Now here's the beauty of this. We can do this at YouTube even though YouTube doesn't have a search volume tool. In other words, we can go to YouTube and see how many child terms each keyword has. We then understand, based on this test, that the terms that have the most children also have the most search volume. You remember earlier when I showed you that picture showing the crowd size. It makes perfect sense that the larger groups and the more people in them, people search differently and therefore more child terms are created. Therefore, we can use the size and the number of the child terms in order to determine the popularity of the parent terms. And that's exactly what you could do to determine which keywords have the most search volume. And that's what prompted us to create Tube Explorer. Tube Explorer is a piece of software that will automatically do exactly what we've just shown you. It has the ability to drill deep into YouTube and find every single child term for any parent term. It can also find children of children terms. It can go as many levels deep as you'd like. And the best part about it is we can actually record the number of children next to each keyword so we instantly know which keywords and which topics have the most traffic on YouTube. So take, for example, bass fishing. We can see exactly how many children are below each keyword and how many children are below those keywords as many levels deep as we like. And by knowing this information and being able to visually see the child keywords below each term, we then get a very, very good idea of which keywords are the most searched keywords on YouTube. And as I showed you previously with the Google video, we've proved this concept that 100% of the time, when you find the terms that have the most children, you find the terms that have the most search volume on YouTube. We also have features like only showing keywords that have child terms so that you don't get your maps don't get too big. You can set the minimum number of children. You have the ability to put in prefixes. So you can put the entire letters of the alphabet and it will find things like best bass fishing, or you can put suffixes and it'll find things like bass fishing tips or bass fishing lures. You also have the ability to make sure that keywords are contained in your terms. So if you want to make sure every keyword has the word bass or fishing in it, you can do that. And you can also exclude terms from ever showing in your maps. That would make sure that things like Xbox and games don't ever show. And the great thing about this is when you're finished, you will have a complete map of an entire topic on YouTube, including all the children, all the children of the children, all the children of the children of the children, the great-grandchildren, if you will. But using this method, we can actually break down every topic in YouTube and find out which topics have the most search volume. Now, as you can see, the ability to know which keywords have the highest search volume on YouTube using Tube Explorer gives you a huge unfair advantage when it comes to getting video views, rankings, getting your links clicked, getting traffic to your site, getting affiliate commissions, etc. But there's another hidden benefit of using Tube Explorer. I put in the prefix and suffix. I included not only the single characters A to Z, but I also included double characters like AA, AB, AC, AD. I did that for both the prefix and the suffix lists. And I didn't actually even let it finish completely. I just let it go through those initial searches. Let me show you what happened next. So in this column here, you can see when I put in the keyword bass fishing at the Google AdWords keyword planner, and then I export those results and I remove any keywords that don't have to do specifically with bass fishing. You can see down this column here that for a single search at the Google AdWords keyword tool, I got 107 results. So there was 107 keywords that the Google AdWords keyword tool brought back specifically dealing with bass fishing. So bass fishing is contained in the actual keyword itself. And then I went over to Tube Explorer because remember, this is a completely different keyword source, but there's a lot of overlap. So keywords that are often typed on YouTube, they're also often typed in Google, and we can find that information out by then taking the keywords that Tube Explorer brings back and just putting them back into the Google AdWords keyword planner, and we will find additional keywords, but we'll also find the search volume for these keywords at Google. So if you compare what the Google AdWords keyword planner brought back to Tube Explorer, I want you to see the difference here. So this Google AdWords keyword planner stopped at 107, so that's where it stopped right there. And so I will show you, look at all the extra keywords. Now every single one of these keywords that Tube Explorer found are keywords that people are typing in every day into YouTube to find videos. But again, they're also related to searches that are made at Google. And you can see there is just an enormous amount of additional keywords that we didn't get on the Google AdWords keyword planner that we were able to get from Tube Explorer. And I'll just keep scrolling down, and this could go on for a long time because again, I didn't even let Tube Explorer finish. I basically canceled it after the very initial search, but it would have drilled into these terms further. So there's over 3,000 terms here that are specifically related to bass fishing that Tube Explorer located that were not given if you put in the term bass fishing at the Google AdWords keyword planner. And I think you can probably already guess why this is important, because so many people doing digital marketing are using the Google AdWords keyword planner as their source for keywords. So these keywords become more competitive, but these terms over here, they're completely overlooked by many people. One, because they don't have a good tool to find YouTube keywords, but two, they don't have a tool that can drill intelligently into the terms. And many of these terms, you'll just take these terms here, go back to the Google AdWords keyword planner, and you can find the search volume. But many of these terms have very significant amounts of search volume, but yet there's very little competition because they haven't yet been discovered by the people in the market, because most people are using this here, or they're using a keyword tool that pretty much relies on the Google AdWords keyword planner as its data source. And so by using a tool like Tube Explorer, you're going to be able to find keywords that other people are completely overlooking. Now, by far, what I think is one of the most powerful features of Tube Explorer is just the fact that it's a visual keyword research tool. So you can see the relationships between keywords, and this will really help when you're creating your videos so that you can make series of videos and batch your videos around a specific topic, and you can actually corner that entire market on YouTube in both the search side as well as the related section side. So if you were going to do some videos around iPod, you could just do a quick search here, and then let's say you wanted to get specifically, you want to do videos about the iPod Touch, and then let's say you're specifically want to do the iPod Touch 6, So again, you're seeing the visual relationship between these terms because we're displaying the information on a mind map as opposed to just a list. And you're able to collapse this information so you can work with this mind map here. You can also, again, I showed you earlier, just copy and paste the keywords as a large list if that's what you're looking to do. But Tube Explorer is extremely flexible. There's a lot of great things you could do with this tool. It's an incredible brainstorming tool. If you're looking to go into a new topic or a new market, it's a great way just to come up with some great ideas and angles and a unique sales proposition for your products and your services using searches that people actually type in to help you narrow down to the right topic, the right market. Now, Tube Explorer will work on a Mac or a PC. It works directly in your browser. It's very easy to get set up and running. Really, it just takes a few seconds. You unzip a file, then you just put in your keyword. I do have some training videos that I'll give you as soon as you purchase, and you can take a look at those training videos, and I have each setting broken down into a different video. So if you just need a quick refresher on what does the prefix do, or how do I use it, or what does the keyword contain feature, or how can I make sure my maps only have the most popular terms, I have all that laid out for you in a video. Just below this video here, there is the order link. Click that link, purchase Tube Explorer, and then as soon as you download it, you can unzip it on your machine, you can put in your keywords, and you can begin to find out for certain which keywords have the highest search volume on YouTube, which keywords have the biggest following, which keywords are going to give you the most views and going to build your channel. It's very, very easy to use, but it's an incredibly powerful tool. So take advantage of that today. Just below this video, you should see a link that will, you can click that link and go straight to our cart and purchase Tube Explorer, and you can have it downloaded and running on your machine in the next 90 seconds.